is, SOLIDWORKS PCB 2017. So we're going to open it up, because one of the things we need to determine now is whether or not the services were also installed, because we need to have these services. What are the services? Basically, it's a container that SOLIDWORKS PCB and SOLIDWORKS CAD need to use in order to communicate back and forth with each other, because it has to know what the head revision is. I do want to check is to make sure that the services did get installed. So far, so good, because we didn't get a prompt and it wasn't grumpy about the fact that it couldn't find it. However, another way we can do this just to make sure that it can find it is under File. And we go under File, we're going to say Sign In SOLIDWORKS PCB Services. So it's going to ask me for an address here, and what we want is to use, unless you have one that's been set up completely different by your administrator, and as long as you don't have a Vault already installed, it should be localhost, and it's going to be 9780. Right, and now I'm going to put in my username. The default is admin, lowercase. The password is also the same as the login initially. So obviously you want to make sure that that works. I'm going to press login over here, and let's see if it can find it. If it can't, then that means the services were not installed. Can't find it at this point in time. So what I'm going to do over here is I need to install the services, and that's fine. So I'm going to close up shop, and I'm going to close this down. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually bring up my features and program. Okay, I've got that up here on my screen. Let's bring it up over here. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go down all the way to SOLIDWORKS. And I'm going to modify it. So it's bringing up the installation manager. So again, we're going to get this reboot. Don't worry about it. Just press OK at this point in time. Now, what we need to do is we need to install the services. So we're not going to do it through the modify individual installation. We're going to do it through server products. And you're going to see a bunch of different products that we need to install. There's only one of them, and it's going to be install SOLIDWORKS PCB services on this computer. Okay, so we're going to click on that and press next. And we're going to go through the same process of it downloading and then installing again. Notice it didn't request any type of serial number for it, because quite frankly, it really doesn't work unless you actually have SOLIDWORKS PCB installed. So I accept the terms of the license, I'm going to download and install it. Okay, now the installation is complete. Again, I'm going to say no thank you to the Experience Improvement Program, and I'm going to finish at this point in time. So I don't expect anything to necessarily pop up on my screen here, but I am going to bring up SOLIDWORKS PCB 2017 again. And is now coming up. And there's my storage manager, which I didn't close the last time, so I am going to close that. That's just one of the panels, the default panels that come up automatically when you start SOLIDWORKS PCB. So I'm going to go into File now, and I'm going to do a Sign In SOLIDWORKS PCB Services. So it's going to now prompt me again. So again, I'm going to put in localhost colon 9780. And I'll put the username in. Again, the default is lowercase admin, and so is the password. One of the things I'll do is I'll tell it to remember the credentials. However, I won't have it sign in always when I do SOLIDWORKS PCB. And the only reason I don't do that is because if there's something that happens where the services doesn't kick up, this can get a little grumpy and it's going to keep asking you a couple times for you to find the services. So I'll bring it up when I need it. And of course, it'll prompt you if you're going to do a new project. It's going to ask you for that anyways. So I'm going to log in at this point in time. And once it's done, if it's happy, really nothing else should really appear at that point in time. What I should be able to do now is if I go into File and I'm going to do a new PCB project, once this comes up over here, you can see that the repository information is now filled in, and that's where it's going to be able to save it. If you have files that you're bringing from Altium, then it's just a matter of going into Open Document and bringing those in. Again, if you are trying to bring in something that's the PCB doc from Altium, there is a little bit of a procedure in order to import it properly into SOLIDWORKS PCB. So hopefully that gives you a little bit of a start here so that you can get moving as quickly as possible. This, by the way, even though the video has been cut short, it took a little bit over an hour. Most of it had to do with the downloading and the installation, but hopefully you can see the key points that are necessary in order to keep the installation moving. So I hope you found this valuable. And we'll put out other videos as we're going along to assist you in your SOLIDWORKS PCB endeavors.